welcome back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, my name is Iyana, and you want to go ahead and press that subscribe button, because if you don't, you're going to be left out the loop. You're going to be trying to find me again on this platform, and you're going to be lost. So go ahead and press subscribe, because I'm reminding you right now. You won't be disappointed. All right, guys, so today I'm going to be giving some tips on transitioning to natural hair. So if you have not transitioned to natural yet and you're already in the stage of trying to become natural and you're looking for some tips, keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing is you can transition to natural without big chopping. So you can big chop all your relaxed ends off, or you can transition for however long you'll like or whatever is comfortable for you. Personally, when I transitioned to natural hair, I did it for about 8 to 10 months. I transitioned for about 8 to 10 months, and then I cut all of my relaxed ends off after that. So you can either big chop completely, or you can just grow your roots out and grow your hair out while still trimming at the ends to get rid of the relaxed ends. So it's those two options. So whatever one you're comfortable with and you are comfortable with, not what anybody else thinks. What you comfortable with, you do. So the first tip is be extremely gentle with your hair. When I was transitioning, I'm not gonna lie, I wasn't gentle. So majority of my relaxed ends had broke off where my natural hair started. So what I mean by being gentle with your hair is you'll have your natural roots. Like you have your natural roots and then your relaxed ends. And then there's like a small little section like right here where your natural hair meets with your relaxed ends. And that's called the line of demarcation. And that's where, you know, your hair is changed at. So it is extremely weak, y'all. When they tell you it's weak, I'm not lying. It's weak because majority of my hair had broke off at that point. Be extremely gentle with your hair when you're taking care of it, because I know it's going to be a pain with the two textures, but believe me, be gentle, take your time. Don't be in a rush when you're doing your hair in a transition state, please. Tip number two that I have is try to blend your hair with your natural hair, not your relaxed ends. Don't blend your natural hair with your relaxed ends by flat ironing it, because that's really gonna damage your hair. So try and do like little styles that actually blend your relaxed ends with your natural hair, like curly hairstyles, like a twist and curl, put a perm rod on it, roll it up, take it out, and it has a little curl, and it blends easily and seamlessly, because I've done that before. Or you can do like a little roller set situation to blend the two textures. When I was transitioning, I had to like 2-strand twists, put it on a roller and roll it up, and it blend like boom. You had like a little curly fro. So try and do that instead of trying to blend the relaxed hair with the natural hair by flat ironing it, because we're not trying to do that, not now. And this brings me into my third tip, where you need to limit the amount of heat that you put on your hair at this time. Don't blow dry your hair, y'all. Just try and let it air dry. Do not flat iron your hair at all. I did it once or twice. I highly recommend not doing that, because you're gonna be damaging your natural hair. And where I was talking about the line of demarcation, that thing gonna snap in half and it's gonna be breakage. So do not flat iron your hair or use any type of heat on your hair. Just let it, you know, let it be. Especially if you're trying to become natural, because most of the time a lot of naturals, we really don't be on that heat like that anyway. So it's basically training you in advance not to use heat like that on your hair. So go ahead and completely don't use heat on your hair while you're transitioning. Another tip I have is, I already talked about it earlier in the video, is to trim your hair as you go. So every so often, like if you're just growing your hair out, you know, every once a month, trim a little bit of the ends of the relaxed ends off, or every 2 months, trim a little bit of the relaxed ends off, so you can get closer and closer and closer to being fabulous with your natural hair, okay? Whatever you're comfortable with, you know, every once a month, trim it in. Every 2 months, trim it in. Whatever you're comfortable with. But I probably recommend doing it once a month to trim your relaxed ends off while your hair is growing in as well. Because I'll really, really make it easier for you actually manipulating your hair. Because If you have so much relaxed ends and then you have your hair coming in and you're still dealing with all that relaxed ends, it's going to get annoying. So go ahead and just like trim as you go and as you go, and then you'll be closer and closer to becoming fully natural. Another tip is very important. This tip is very important. Try protective styles. This will really help you, y'all. I think I did one or two protective styles. I did one protective style when I was transitioning, and it was like little twists. That really helped, y'all. Without me manipulating my hair all the time, that really helped. And it really helped with some growth at my roots and everything. Try some protective style, like Marley twist, braids, wigs. What else? Just put your hair in a little bun. Like, try a protective style. Whatever protective style you like, just try it on your hair while you're transitioning, because it will help tremendously, y'all, with the growth and the time and the stress. I'm not gonna lie, it's stressful, but when you have protective styles, especially nowadays, because when I was transitioning back then, it wasn't like a lot of styles that was like out, that's out right now. So I just did like little twists and that helped. So try doing protective styles while you're transitioning. Another tip I have is go ahead while you're transitioning, or before you even transition, or you already transitioning, replace all the hair tools you have that you have for your relaxed hair, and get some tools that are natural hair friendly. Do not get a rat tail comb and try and detangle your hair with the two textures. Don't do it. Please don't do it, because one of us goes in and we all going through it. Do not do that. Trade your tools in for like a wide tooth comb. If you're into dimming brushes, get a good dimming brush, a tangle teaser, stuff like that. Don't be trying to use no rat tail comb. Go ahead and throw that away, because you're not even going to need it when you become natural. You're just not going to need it. Go ahead and replace those types of combs or those types of hair tools that you have with natural hair friendly hair tools, because you're going to need it. And also, you're going to need a spray bottle. I'm just telling you. Another tip I have is a great tip. I wish I would have did more of this when I was transitioning, but while you're transitioning, you want to go ahead and experiment with some products, natural hair products. So you go ahead and feel like what your natural hair likes. Go ahead and figure that out a little more now before you become fully natural. That's one thing I wish I would have did when I like went fully natural and transitioning and everything. Pick up some products and, you know, try it out on your hair and see how your hair feels, or see how your hair reacts to those products, so you already know how your hair will react when you're fully natural. So I think that'll be a great idea and best to do while you're transitioning, so you already know, like, once you cut all them ends off, you'd be like, Shea Moisture, I already know you like, I already know how you work. Curls, I already know how you work. Talia YG, I already know how you work on my hair, so I'm gonna go ahead and snap that up when I become fully natural. So I just thought that would be a great tip to put in. Another tip I have is to stay positive. Have a positive mindset. Stay strong. I know y'all strong. I always tell y'all are strong. So stay strong during this time period, because your hair is definitely changing. So what I mean by this is the amount of time you spend on your hair will drastically change from when you're transitioning to being fully natural. The amount of time you spend on your hair while you was relaxed is drastically different from the amount of time you will spend doing your natural hair. So stay strong. Go ahead and prepare your mind for that, because when I was transitioning, I was like, man, this is taking taking a while to do. It's all worth it, so stay strong. I'm just being honest with you guys. The time that you're doing and spending on your hair will change dramatically. Yeah, dramatically. And also with the time that you're spending doing your hair, the manageability of your hair will change as well. Obviously, you know, if you have, you know, straighter hair, it's a breeze. But with natural hair, you do need to take your time, and the manageability of your hair is going to be different than what it was when you were relaxed. So, I mean, natural hair, once you figure out your natural hair, you're going to be like, manageability, boom, 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 done. But I know if you're transitioning, you're not really used to all that. So I'm just giving you a heads up. Your time that you spend on your hair is going to be different, and the manageability of your hair is going to be different as well. So just go ahead and prepare your mind, because you got this. You strong. I know you strong. Go ahead and do that. Another key tip I have is Do not obsess with other people's hair textures on YouTube, on social media, on pictures, or whatever. Do not do that. I'm not gonna lie, I was like that when I was transitioning. I was like, I wonder after I, you know, become natural, is my hair gonna look like this? Or is it gonna look like her hair? Cause her hair is pretty. How is it gonna look? Don't do that, because if you do that and you cut your hair, you cut the remaining relaxed ends off your hair and it's not what you were expecting or what you were looking for, you're gonna be disappointed. Do not obsess over other people's hair textures, y'all. That's a big no-no. Just do what you do. You can look at other people's you know, YouTube or, you know, other stuff like that that have similar textures, but you won't know your full texture until you cut the ends off your hair. But you know, once you do that, then you can relate to other people that have similar textures as you, but nobody will have your exact texture or your exact head of hair. So just know that. Do not obsess with other people's curl patterns or curl types or head of hair, because your head of hair is different from mine. It's different from hers. It's different from that person sitting next to you. Just don't obsess. And my last tip I could give to you guys is be patient, especially if you're not doing a big chop where you're just natural right away and you're transitioning. You have to have patience. You have to have patience. Regardless if you're transitioning for 3 months, 2 years, 3 years, 8 months, but whatever amount of time that you are comfortable with, what you are comfortable with, not anybody else. If you're comfortable with it, you do it. But whatever amount of time you think about, you know, transitioning, be patient, stick with it. I recommend having a date already in your head, like, okay, I'm a transition for such and such month, or I'm a transition for a year, and then that's it. Just go ahead and set a date in your head so you can keep being motivated. Be motivated so you know when it's time and when it's good, okay? So keep being patient, y'all. It's gonna be a journey. But that's the sweetness of it, because when you get there, you're going to be like dancing in the wind and everything. So be patient, y'all. All right, guys. So that's all the tips I have for you guys. Hopefully they're helpful and hopefully you learn something and take some type of tips from this video. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to share. Sharing is caring. We gotta help people out here, y'all. So share this video with whoever you know who is transitioning or thinking about transitioning. Share this video. Don't forget to like, comment. Don't forget to subscribe, because we want to see you again. We love you. So go ahead and press subscribe. Don't forget, you're beautiful, you are strong, and you are the best music. And I will see you guys in my next one.